22 years of age. The first time he met Queen Victoria was many years later when he traveled to London. And over a period of several years before his untimely passing in 1891, he grew very close to the Queen on a personal level, but I think it further ingrained his understanding of what constitutional monarchy was all about and just how important an institution it was to Canada then. And I think we can all agree how important an institution it is to Canada now. And part of all our collective work, with the blessing of Sir John A. looking down upon us, is to ensure that many more Canadians come to a greater understanding and appreciation of constitutional monarchy and the Crown of Canada. As I mentioned earlier, Sir John's greatest accomplishment was seeing the creation of this great country. One of his other accomplishments, for which he was sorely criticized at the time, was the creation of a ribbon of steel from one end of this country to the other. It was an initiative that not only ensured the survival of this country, but ensured that it would flourish, and that all its peoples, from Aboriginals to French Canadians to English Canadians and to all the myriad of other nationalities who came here, would live in prosperity and freedom under the crown. Sir John was often quoted as saying, "Let us be English, let us be French, but above all, let us be Canadian." And I think the words of Sir John would echo true today. I think Sir John would be very pleased with the rich multicultural diversity that is the fabric of Canadian society. But I think Sir John would probably repeat his very words now, as he did in the 1860s. Let us be English, let us be French, let us be whatever our original ancestral roots were. But above all, let us be Canadian. I think it's important to point out that we are standing in front of two statues tonight. The statue, obviously, of Sir John A., the Dominion's first Prime Minister, but directly behind the statue of Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II, the statue that the Queen unveiled 20 years ago this year. As I mentioned earlier, Sir John was an avid supporter of the institution. He understood it. He appreciated it. It's important for us to note that this year we have already entered the Diamond Jubilee year of Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II as Queen of Canada. In fact, the actual date, as you will know, is in about 3 weeks' time. February 6th, 2012 is the actual date of the 60th anniversary of Her Majesty's ascension to the throne. So with the Queen looking upon us and looking at Sir John A., I say to both Sir John A. and the Queen, well done. To Sir John, I say, God bless you. And to the Queen, I say, God bless you and save you. So on your behalf, and on behalf of all Canadians, I will now lay these flowers at the foot of Sir John's statue.
Cheers to Kevin.